Hello everyone, myself Ankit Shivare. Today we are going to discuss on problem sessions. So this is our first problem. I am taking problem from Behzad Rezavi. So from chapter number 4 we have started, right? So the question here is the capacitance between adjacent lines is given 10 femtofarad. Now you have to talk means what is the glitches that you will get in the other end, right? So suppose this is one problem. So this is one resistance, this transistor something, and this is signal line, right? And one clock is passing through it, right? So it will be passing some glitches when it is going on and off transition, right? We know that if any digital pulse passes, then the glitches is observed in the other end, right? So we are trying to find out that what is the amount of glitch that you can get, right? So here we are, in this problem, we are going to learn that it is actually the differential that saves you from the amount of glitches that you get, right? So we'll see how it is coming. So the funda here, first we should go to the funda, so that we can understand the concepts very quickly. So funda is, like, suppose you have a resistor R1 R2, right, and you have a amount of current flowing through it, right? And now this is delta V we are showing. So actually it is delta V, that is the amount of jump that you are getting. So what is the amount of effect you will get in V2? So simple is R2 by R1 plus R2 into R2 into delta V, that is the amount of glitch you will see in this across R2. So how we have got it is this V is equal to I into R1 plus R2. And V2, that is current will be same, right? The current that is passing through R1 and R2 will be same as the current that is passing through R2, right? So V2 is I2 times R, I times R2. Now equate it. So I is what, V by R1 plus R2 into R2, delta V you are getting. So this is the amount of jump you are getting across R2. So same you can solve for capacitor, right? It's not a magic. So V is I into R. Here is V is I into 1 by j omega C. So amount of glitch that is here is delta V. So I into 1 by j omega C equivalent. So now delta V2 that you will get is what? I into 1 by j omega C2. So I is, again you replace it. So what you get is delta V into j omega C equivalent. And C equivalent, you know that when it is in series, it's C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. So when you cancel it, so you will get is C1 by C1 plus C2. So here the resistor is R2 by R1 plus R2 into delta V. Here it is what? C1 by C1 plus C2 into delta V. So capacitance resistance are opposite. You can see by this, because it's division here, right? And here it is multiplication. So now you apply the same funda here. So suppose delta 3 volt is jump across this line L2, right? This is line L2, that is 0 to 3 volt jump you are getting, right? So here it is what, in line 1, what the glitch you will observe is 10 by 100 plus 10 into 3. So this is 10, that is C1 by C1 plus C2 into delta V, 0.273. Now suppose you have a differential. So now this clock is in between, and this is our line 1 L2. Now we are seeing the difference V L2 and L3. So what is the amount of glitch we will see now? So first we should calculate V L2 here, V L3 here, and take the difference, right? So that is the amount of glitch we will get. So delta V2 is what? 9 by 9 plus 100 into 3. So it is plus 3 volt here change, and here it is what? It is minus 3, because so if suppose this is plus 3 for this end, so this will be what? For this end it will be seeing minus 3, right? So it is 0.248 you will get, and here it is 0.273. now when you add these two, so what you will get is 25 millivolt. So that is the amount of glitch you will see, that is delta V23. Delta V23 is difference, right? So 0.273 minus 0.248, that is 25 millivolt. Okay, so actually we are means adding these two, VL23, that is what actually we are doing, right? So when we are adding these two, so we are seeing that, suppose this is positive glitch you are seeing here, this will be here, will be this will here be again a glitch, right? So if this is positive glitch here, so again you are seeing that it is the positive glitch here as well. It's negative glitch here, so you are seeing a negative glitch here as well, right? Because this positive that is coming up here, that is delta V, right? So this is increasing here, so this is also increasing here. So yeah, so it is increasing for both end, right? So sorry, so delta V23 is 25 millivolts. So sorry. So this is what we will get, right? So I was just adding it up, right? So you should understand that I was seeing it to be negative, but this is actually positive and here going. So but here also it is seeing the same positive end, right? Because it's, you see from here or see from here, so you are seeing the same positive triggering that is happening up. So yeah, okay. So we will see the further problems. Thank you. Thank you for watching.